You honestly, I've never ever met someone so stubborn. Yeah, you're asking questions that do not relate to anything. We Muslims don't think about this stuff. Yeah, we don't.
What do you mean you don't think? You know, I'm asking you. It says there, أن يكون له ولد ولم تكن له صاحبة. How he will have a son if he never had a girlfriend? So what do you mean you don't care? What do we care? We want an answer. You don't mind. People in the room, do you care? Do you care to know why Allah is saying to us, you know, I don't have a girlfriend? If he is God, how God say to us, I don't have a girlfriend? How stupid such a thing to be? Why, he's a man like us? He had a girlfriend too? And even he's not using the word wife, he's using the word girlfriend, sahiba. Like, shame on him. At least say, I never have a wife. Secondly, suppose that this verse is to answer the Christians about Jesus, the Son of God. Guys, any one of the Christians believe that Jesus is the son of Mary because God have sex with Mary? Never. Even your Quran itself says Mary is virgin. So this verse is very stupid. If she is the Virgin Mary, even in your book, not only in our book. So what does God is talking about here? How I'm going to have a son when I never have a girlfriend? And here he's talking about sexual relationship. When all of us we knew, even in your book and in our book, Mary is a virgin. So he is saying to us, I never have a sexual relationship with a woman, so I don't have a son. Proving what? That he don't have a son. Why? Because he never have sex with a woman. Why? Because he didn't have a girlfriend. This is the most stupid things ever I can hear. You know what?
Look, no, you don't understand me, Christian Prince, yeah? And John Christian, stop sending me private messages, please, it's annoying. CP, Christian Prince, well, like I said, okay, these questions are of no value to us, yeah? Whether you ask me or not, we don't answer, we don't discuss certain matters. Simple as, God created you, worship him, end of, submit, that's it. You made me call me a goat, sheep, follower, whatever, but that's how we do it, yeah? We are just created to worship him, and we just worship him. That's it. We just accept it like that. You worship humans. You worship him.
You know, you are against me to worship a human, but you worship a leg. And he said to me, I have no sahiba. I want you to tell the room, why your God saying, I don't have a sahiba. I don't have a girlfriend. They are mad from a Christian for worshiping a man. For them, it's okay. They don't ask why Allah is a lake. It's okay. So how you accept Allah to be a lake, your mind?
Who said I accept Allah to be a God to be a lake? God said he had a lake. That's all. He does not say he is a lake, you idiot. You're so stupid, I swear to God. Are you worshiping a...
So he's a man? Or he is just a lake? We want an answer. When we say to you, he is just a leg, you get upset. Allah is a leg with a butt and waist and a chest, or he is just a leg, you mind. Here we go, he will never answer. Go ahead.
I know exactly what you're trying to do, yeah? And I know exactly why you're asking that question, yeah? But that question, yeah?
As long as you know, I want an answer. Allah is just a leg or he's a full man? Either you say he's just a lake, or you say he's a full man. Guys, anything wrong with my question? They don't accept Jesus to be God for he's a man. They accept Allah to be a lake. We are asking him, Allah is just a lake or he's a full man? He don't want to answer. They accept to us, to say to us, that you know what? Allah have a lake. But they don't want to say to us if he's just a leg or he's a part-time leg or, you know, maybe he lost his butt or something. So we want an answer. Don't give me a speech. Allah is a leg by himself or he's a full man? You're mine.
The questions you're asking, can only be comprehended by a brain of a human. Yeah, God is beyond that. So
thank you very much. This means that my question proving that Allah is a human too. Why? Because it's Allah himself who said he have a leg, and the leg is something comprehended by the brain of the human. Because if Allah's leg is not like any leg, why he saying to us, I have a leg? What's the point? And you know what? Let me ask you a question, very easy one. Why he want to show his leg even? Why he want to show his leg? What about showing his face? Like, I never heard about somebody, he want to show himself to me, he show his butt. Which one should Allah show? His face or his leg? Your mind.
He will
show me where the Quran say he will show his leg. Your mind.
وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها الآيات.
Yeah, they will see their God, but it doesn't say they will see they will see the face of Allah. And this is what the verse saying, they will see his leg. Come on, buddy. There is nowhere in the Quran it says you will see the face of Allah. Actually, they came to your prophet, they said to him, are we going to see Allah in the judgment day? This, he said, yes. They said, how? He said, are you going to be heard to see the sun in the middle of the day? They said, no. He said, are you going to be heard to see the moon in the clear sky? They said, no. He said, this is how you will see Allah. They said, how we will know him? He said, he will go on to show his shin. He will show his leg. So all what you will see of Allah is a shin. So the face of Allah must be his shin. Your mind. And if Allah has a face, and if they will see his face, why he's showing his shin only? Your mind.
The tafsir for that verse, the tafsir for that verse says it was a face. And I go back to what I say.
What verse? Tell me please. Because I want to pause the tafsir for it, please. No mind.
The same verse we're talking about.
What the same verse? Chapter 68, verse number 42? 68:42, am I? What's wrong, man? What verse? 68:42, am I?
I don't have the reference with me, but it's the verse.
You don't have a reference. You said to me the same verse. You don't know what verse we are talking about. So you are arguing with me even. You do not know what the verse we are speaking about. And it's not up to you, sir. We can show you the explanation. The explanation is so clear. This is the shin of Allah. Allah will show his shin. Here we go. This is Ibn Kathir open. People, they are posting for you. In the judgment of day, Allah will show his shin. This is the explanation of Ibn Kathir. You mind.
May Allah guide you all. May God guide you all. Allahu musta'an.
Is that an answer? May Allah guide you all. Well, let me show you how ignorant about your Quran. You cannot ask Allah for guidance because the Quran says, pray for them not, because I am the one who deceived them. It's in the Quran. It is Allah who deceived me. What's wrong with you? Because Allah in the Quran says, if I deceive somebody, no guidance for him. He is the deceiver. Now we have a guy in here, keep saying sahiba, sahiba. What sahiba? The in. Are you there? What's wrong with sahiba?